report up.
And all that.
Crime Waves by Dave Simpson and Diane Whiteley. Episode 1, The Trial. News from the Northwest on Radio Northside with James Edwards.
The PC Johnson murder trial begins today at Manchester Crown Court. The accused is 19-year-old Keith Brandon from Salford.
Passes the milk.
Police constable William Johnson was found stabbed to death on the ground near Parkvale Youth Centre on the evening of January the 20th.
Somebody answer that door!
All right. Dad! We were listening, it's about Keith.
So stop listening and get moving, you're late for school.
But we know him.
Yes, and I worry about some of the people you two know.
Hi, Gemma.
Is it like this in your house, Andy? Bedlam?
Sometimes.
Oh, and by the way, I'm working late tonight. Fancy a takeaway pizza?
Oh, Meggie, yeah.
See you tonight.
Hey, Dad, try and get that Pro Walkman tape recorder for us.
Look, I can't today, I'm up to here.
Oh, Dad.
Well, I work at the BBC, Gemma, not Curry's Superstore.
Oh, and you will ask if we can go in the editing suite?
No!
I can't find me tie.
Hey, Liam. I haven't been able to fix that tape deck.
You're joking. We need it for Friday's disco.
I know.
Have you seen me tie, Gemma?
No.
Look, Andy, I've one more go at fixing it tonight. And if it doesn't work, maybe my dear sister will look at it for us. Hey, Gemma.
I've never been to court.
You what?
I wonder what Keith's doing now.
Having his last cigarette.
Let's go.
No, I still can't find my tie.
Not school, idiot. Court.
You're joking. You mean... bunk off?
Yeah. I'm going to go to Keith's trial. You two coming with me?
Are you serious?
Andy?
No way.
Come with us, Liam.
I don't know.
You're mad, Gemma. What if you get caught?
I want to be at Keith's trial. It's important. Are you coming with me or not, Liam?
Don't be daft, Liam.
Shut up, Andy. Liam?
Hmm.
Well?
All right.
Brill!
The pair of you are mad.
Not really. This way you won't get detention, will I?
You what?
I can't find my skill tie. Can
I? Come on, Brandon, on your feet.
All right.
They're waiting for you.
You know something? Your breath smells.
Yeah, come on.
Mr. A. Reynolds, court number 2.
Which court's Keith in?
Don't ask me.
Hey, Liam, he's in here.
What?
It's on the door, come on.
Hey, where are you going?
Into court.
Oh, yes, and how old are you?
14.
And you, young lady?
13.
If you're under 14, you can't go in.
But I'm 14 tomorrow.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I am. Oh, please, he's our friend, Keith Brandon. We promised we'd be here.
Hang on. And you're meant to be accompanied by an adult.
Oh, well,
And anyway, shouldn't you be at school?
No, we've got special permission.
Mrs. Brandon, it's over here.
Thank goodness.
We're with her.
Oh, I couldn't remember the court number. Hello, you're...
Friend to Keith, yeah.
Hello, Mrs. Brandon. Let's go in, shall we? It's just starting.
Are they with you?
Yes,
aren't we?
Yes.
All right, then. Go on in.
Thank you. You all right, Mrs. Brandon?
Couldn't sleep worrying about him.
Well, we didn't do it, Mrs. Brandon, so he's going to be all right.
Put up the accused.
Silence in court.
There he is.
Oh, look at him. He hasn't even had a shave.
All stand. Chief Brandon, you stand indicted that on January the 20th, 1992, you did murder Police Constable William Johnson. How say you, Keith Brandon? Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty.
Ooh.
Bring in the jury.
Police Constable Gibson, can you tell us what happened on the night of January the 20th?
PC Johnson and I were on patrol when at 20:45 hours, we received a call concerning a disturbance at the disco in Parkvale Youth Centre. We arrived at the youth centre at 20:50 hours.
And here's two old members here with no limit.
Jeff Carter around!
Yeah! I'm dead!
daughter's son, are you?
That's right.
Who? Jenny Walsh. The blonde one in CID.
Oh, her.
Shall I take you through to Jeff?
Why weren't you on the door, Keith?
I know. Sorry.
It was my fault, Jeff. We were in the pool room talking.
Okay, okay. Forget it. Come.
Police, Jeff.
Right, come in.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks, Andy. Everything okay out there?
Yeah.
Gemma, go and pull the bolt on the front door while we're in here talking, just to be on the safe side, yeah?
Right.
I'll watch the door.
No, you stay, Keith, please.
I'm P.T. Johnson. This is my colleague, P.C. Gibson.
You're a bit late. They've already gone.
What exactly happened?
Some older lads' gate crashed. The disco's for under-16s. It all got a bit heavy.
They broke a couple of glasses, threatening the kids and stuff.
Keith Brandon?
Yeah?
Well, over 16 yourself. Didn't think kiddies' discos would be your idea of fun.
I work here.
Work? Well, well, well.
Look. Do you want a description of these youths?
Yes, please.
So how long's Keith been working for you?
A year and a half.
Notice anything go missing during that
Watch
time?
Watch it!
I hope you're not threatening me, son.
Look, what is this? Oh,
come on, Bill, you're out of order.
These young offenders, criminal record as long as your arm, they get to 18 and it's all wiped clean. Well, that's all wrong, innit?
Look, I know all about Keith's past. I thought you were here to investigate a disturbance, not to harass one of my employees.
Oh, would you like to make a formal complaint, sir?
Oink, oink, oink.
Keith.
You little bastard!
Bill, come on, calm it.
He almost broke my leg once, you know, resisting arrest, he did.
Next time I will.
What did he say? What did he say just then?
Just leave it, Bill, he's not worth it.
Did you definitely hear the defendant threaten Police Constable Johnson?
Yes. He threatened to break his leg.
Liar!
Silence in court.
Thank you, Police Constable Gibson.
They should have asked Jeff. It wasn't like that.
Look, if you can't keep quiet, you'll have to get out.
Sorry.
You've been warned.
Police Constable Gibson, if you heard such a threat, why didn't you arrest Mr. Brandon there and then?
Who's this now?
He's defence lawyer. Shut up, will you, Gemma?
Isn't threatening a police officer an offence?
If we make an arrest on every veiled threat, we'd never do any other police work.
Thank you, Police Constable Gibson.
Does Your Honour have any questions?
Yes, where's my water jug? I usually have a jug and glass. Could someone oblige?
Your Honour?
What? Oh, no. You may stand down, Police Constable Gibson.
I call Detective Inspector Machin. You were the investigating officer on this particular case?
Yes, ma'am.
Could you tell us how your inquiries led you to suspect that the defendant was responsible for Police Constable Johnson's murder?
PC Johnson's body was found by the youth centre, and we know that earlier in the evening, Brandon had threatened PC Johnson, so we brought him in for questioning.
What did the defendant say when you told him why you wanted to question him?
May I refer to my notes, Your Honour?
Yeah, you ought, sir.
Thank you.
Your Honour?
Yes, yes.
He said, Johnson's dead, serves him right.
And did the defendant immediately confess to the murder?
No, not immediately.
You were the interviewing officer?
Yes, me and D.S. Davies.
And at what point did Brandon confess to the murder?
We found a knife in his possession, and when we put it to him that this was the murder weapon, he broke down and made a full confession.
Exhibit number one, please.
Is that Keith's knife?
Looks like it. I know he had it with him at the disco.
Is this the knife?
Go on.
I do not like
green. Good.
I do not like green eggs and ham.
Who, what?
Go on.
Oh, I feel a right nerd reading this.
Concentrate. And Keith, please stop banging your penknife up and down. It's driving me bonkers.
This isn't a penknife. It's a serious blade, this.
The deceased had 6 stab wounds to his chest and 1 to his abdomen.
Now, Mr. Cummings, is it possible that knife could have been used in the attack?
It is possible, yes.
Do the size of the stab wounds.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.